Solvete omnes. Today we're looking at extra here. So you have Gallii, so the Gauls. Captivi, greatly captivated greatly, maxime, by but the sweet fruits, this is an ablative, by sweet fruits, because of the sweet fruits, it could be an ablative cause even, of Italy, and by the wine, crossed the Alps, okay, and proceeded against the Romans. Okay, this is the Gallic invasion around 380 BC. But, although the Romans fighting had often created a dictator, this is a concessive cum clause, fighting with neighboring people often had created a dictator, so the office of dictator, or elected a dictator, at that time, they sought nothing of extraordinary power or of help. And these are part of genitives. Okay? Plurimum terroris, another part of genitives. Celeritas, now watch out, ins and tas is third declension, that the swiftness of the enemy brought very much of terror, or say great, very much terror, okay, to the Romans. At the river Allia, the Romans were conquered. Okay? Maximum pars, the greatest part of the Romans, so the Roman army, another part of genitive, or genitive the whole, fled to the city of Veii. Okay? Nothing of protection, they miserunt to Rome. They sent nothing in protection, again a part of gen, to Rome. Others sought Rome. Okay? And with not even the gates of the city. Nay, plus quidem here is not even. And an ablative absolute. With not even the gates of the city having been closed, they fled, fugerunt, in Arca. Now it's in plus the accusative, so it's into the citadel. So easily were the Romans conquered. Ut, as a result, the Gauls, marveling, first stood, fearing, this is a PAP, Laurentius, from Warrior, we see this a lot in this one, fearing treachery. Finally, they proceeded to the city. Okay, I'm going to move this up a little bit. Alright, cum. And then we have here cum equites. So when the horsemen had reported, Rutilus, then we get an indirect statement here. Non portas urbis clausus, and there's an essay understood that the gates of the city had not been closed, and that there was no soldiers on the walls, nevertheless fearing insidias and noctem, treachery and night. They placed their camp, pitched camp, between Rome and the river Anius. Okay? Cum. Since, this is a cum causal, since there was no hope, nulla spes, of defending the city, the Romans constituerunt decided that the young men, or the young men of military age, let's make it even a date. I know it's nominative, but this is like a, it's like an ut clause here. When you say decide, in English we say decide to, so let's go ahead and keep that going here because it sounds the most natural. So decide for the young men of military age to withdraw with the women and with the children into the citadel and the Capitoline Hill. There, with grain having been collected, ablative absolute, they prepare to defend the gods, the men, and the name of Rome. Alright, we're almost, we're flipping on the backside. Fast forward this. All right. Okay. However, Senes. So we're going now, we're going to get the whole old men section. However, the old men, and it's because the young men and the women all, and the children all went into the citadel. Nevertheless, the old men, maluerin, preferred to expectare, to wait for the adventum, the arrival of the enemy in their idibus, in their houses, with their mind fixed on death. Those men, 80, who, and this is describing, who had been magistrates, literally who had been magistrates, in the most, having been clothed, vestiti, in the most august or most fancy clothing, sat in the middle of their houses, okay, in ivory chairs. On the next day, at a little time when the Gauls, having entered Ingressi, this is a perfect participle of deponent, so it's from ingrediore, but we say, having entered the city, they rushed to loot, so hurried to loot. Then, full of reverence, these are the Gauls, they looked at, who did they look at? The men sitting, the Roman men sitting, sedentes, P-A-P, sitting, who seemed, for all the clause here, who seemed, on account of their clothing and majesty and gravitas, their seriousness, seemed, and an essay has been left out, to be most similar to the gods. When the Gauls, okay, when the Gauls stood to them, just as to, or having turned to them, just as, let's see. Where is he going with the Gauls? So the Gauls, having turned to them, those sitting men, just as to imagines, as just as to statues, like statues of the gods, one unus of the old men, okay, asinibus, percussit, hit a Gaul, and then we have who was, this is describing what the Gaul was doing, who was hitting, who was stroking the man's beard, and he hit him with an ivory staff. So a Gaul came up to him and touched his beard, and then he smacked him with his ivory staff. Not so good. This fuit was the initium, the beginning of the slaughter. The rest of the men, Roman men, were killed in their houses. Okay, place where, after the slaughter of these first people, literally, it was spared for no one, but we could say no one was spared. Houses were plundered and fires were thrown in. But the Gauls had not yet tried to seize the citadel, so there might still be hope. Olecte omnes lingua latina est vita.